Hello everyone, myself Professor S.C. Abang, lecturer in Mechanical Engineering Department, CSMSS College of Polytechnic, Aurangabad. Today we will discuss or we will see the numerical on knuckle joint. So take one numerical on knuckle joint. A knuckle joint is to withstand a load of 30 kN. Design the joint if permissible stresses are sigma t equal to 56 newton per mm square, tau equal to 35 newton per mm square, and sigma ck equal to 70 newton per mm square. So solve this equation or solve this problem with step by step. The first step, or collect the given data from the given numerical. So given data is P or W, we can consider W also. Load carried by the rods, which is given 30 kN, convert it into in the form of Newton, 30 into 10 raised to power 3 Newton. D is the diameter of rod, which is I had considered. So next one is the next parameter is sigma t. Sigma t is given. Sigma t is nothing but the tensile stress equal to 56 newton per mm square. Again, tau is given. Tau is equal to 35 newton per mm square, and tau is nothing but the shear stress, and sigma ck equal to, sigma ck is nothing but the crushing stress, which is given 70 newton per mm square. So solve step by step. The first step is failure of rod in tension. It is a rod which has which is having diameter d. So the rod may get fail in tension due to the tensile load p or w. So that due to that p, the rod may fail. So that we know that area resisting tearing pi by 4 d square, where d is the diameter of rod. So that considering the tensile failure, sigma t equal to p upon area, which is p upon pi by 4 d square. From this equation we have to calculate the diameter of rod. So d square is equal to, d square is equal to 4p divided by pi into sigma t. So that therefore calculate the parameter or diameter. 4 into p is 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by pi into sigma. What will be the sigma? 56 newton per mm square is given. Put the values in calculator, find out the d. The diameter will be 26.11 mm. So that which is equal to 28 mm, say, because it is a diameter we are considering, it is a even value. Hence the diameter d is determined and value of d is 28 mm. Second step, step second A, diameter of pin considering shearing failure or shearing of a pin. So it is a knuckle pin. The first or the upper part and this lower part is contacted in the fork, and this part, middle part, is in the eye, single eye. So that the breakage or the failure will be occur like this. So that this surface and this surface will fail out, and this surface and this surface are coincides, so that between these surfaces the stress will develop. That stress is called as shear stress. So that it is the first surface and it is the second surface, it is undergo the double shear, so that the resisting area will be what will be the area where d1 is the diameter of that single or knuckle pin. Therefore multiply by 2 because of double shear into circular cross section pi by 4 and d1 square, area will become pi 2 into pi by 4 d1 square. So by 2, therefore the considering shear failure means tau is equal to, it is in shear failure, so that considering shear failure tau is equal to again P upon area, area put the values P divided by pi by 2 d1 square. Therefore d1 square equal to 2P divided by pi into tau. Put the values 2 into 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by pi into what is the value of tau is 35. The d1 will become, what will be the d1? D1 will become 23.35 mm. Therefore this diameter is also to be calculated using empirical relation in step second B for more safer design. So come to the step second B, fix the dimensions by using empirical relations. So that diameter of pin d1 equal to d, what will be the d1 and what is the d? D is a 28 mm, so d1 equal to 28 mm. Second, outer diameter of an eye or single eye, which is d2, 2 times of d, 2 into 28, which is equal to 56 mm. Next, diameter of knuckle pin head or collar, which is 1.5 times of d, means 1.5 into 28, which is 42 mm. Thickness of single eye small t is equal to 1.25 times of d, which is 35 mm. T1, thickness of fork, which is 0.75 into 28, which is equal to 21 mm. And thickness of single eye, which is T2 equal to 0.5 into 28, which is equal to 14 mm. In this way we can fix the dimensions of the knuckle joint, and checking the various stresses induced. The next step is third step, checking the failure of single eye in tension across the slot. Across the slot means it is a slot, in this slot it is a weakest section, in this area or in this section the failure will be occurred like this. So this failure area we have to consider, so that this is a d2, this is d1, d1 is the internal diameter of single eye and d2 is the outer diameter of single eye. Consider in this numerical it is as a distance and t is a thickness of a single eye. So the cross section will be like this, so that consider this area d2 and d1. We have to subtract this slotted area of the internal surface of this knuckle pin from the total area, so that the equation or the area under tearing becomes, we are considering tensile failure. Whenever we are applying tensile load on the joint, the failure will be occur like this. We are considering tensile, it will be pull from this side, it will pull to this joint, or again the fork is on another side, it will pull to another direction, so that this failure will be occur. Then area will become, so area resisting tearing will be this d2 minus d1 into t. Okay, d2 minus d1 into t. T is the thickness of single wire, so that the induced stress will be sigma t equal to, what will be the sigma t equal to, p upon area, p and area is d2 minus d1 into t, so that what is p, 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by, what is the value of d2, 56 minus 28 into, what is the thickness is 35. The stress will be equal to, or induced stress will be 30.61 newton per mm square, which is less than 70 newton per mm square. The permissible stress is given, which is 70 newton per mm square, and the induced stress is 30.61 newton per mm square. Say, step 4th, checking the failure of single eye in crushing stress. So it is the most important step, in which step we are considering the failure design is safe or not. So checking the crushing crushing stress should not exceed the permissible limit. Therefore the area will become, see here it is the contact of pin and this surface of single eye, internal surface of single eye, so the crushing stress will develop in this area, so that it is only contacted area. At this area the crushing stress will be developed. The crushing stress is nothing but the, it is the stress, but there is a no relative motion between them, or it is the contact surface having the contact, but there is no relative motion between them, then the stress induced is called as crushing stress. So in this area the crushing stress will be developed, then we have to consider only this area. So we are having a whole area means it is having d2, we have to consider this area. It means that d2 minus d1 into t, how much of having that much area, d1 into t, sorry, not d2 minus d1, directly we can calculate, we don't have to subtract the value, we just consider whole value or whole. In this section the crushing stress will be developed, so that d1 into t area will become, area under crushing will become d1 into t, so that the induced crushing stress means sigma ck equal to p upon area, so p is, and area is d1 into t. Put the values, p is 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by area. What is the value of d1? 28 and t 35. So the induced stress will become 30.61 newton per mm square, which is also less than 70 newton per mm square. So in this again we can consider the induced crushing stress is less than the permissible crushing stress. It means that our design will be safe. Come to the next step, step 5th, checking the failure of single eye in shear. In shearing, we are considering the single eye, the failure will be like this. So this is a piece will be weared out from this single eye. Whenever applying a tensile load, it will undergo the shear stress. This surface and this surface and this surface and this surface will develop the shear stress in the body of single eye, so it will fail. So the breakout area will be d2 minus d1 divided by 2. How? It is a distance considered from center, it is a d1 by 2 and it is a d2 by 2. So d1 by 2 minus d1 by 2, these are same. So directly d2 minus d1 divided by 2. So that again area will be, what will be the area? Consider only this area. Okay, so d2 minus it is a shear stress will be developed in this body. So how much times or how much surfaces are in contact? It is the first surface, it is a second surface, so it is in double shear. Area will become double shear due to that double shear, 2 into d2 minus d1 divided by 2, 2 to get cancel into the thickness. So area will become d2 minus d1 into t. Therefore the induced shear stress will be tau equal to p upon area. So p upon area d2 minus d1 into t. Put the values, p is 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by 56 minus 28 into 35, which is equal to, what will the value? 30.61 newton per mm square. So which is also less than 70 newton per mm square. So that in this step also we are considering or we are checking the induced shear stress will be less than given permissible stresses. Next, step 6th. In this step, checking the failure of fork end means double eye in tension across the slot. So consider this diagram as we have seen in the design procedure. It is a fork, it has two end, it is upper end, it is a lower end. So that in this fork, consider this area, this darkened area will consider it is a failure area. The total parameter is d2 and the unconsiderable parameter is d1. So it is in tensile failure. When you are applying same like a single eye, when you are applying the load or a tensile load on the fork and in the other hand on the single eye, this fork will be break like this. So at this end, the more tensile stress is developed, so it will break like this. So this total area is d2 and this area is d1, and the thickness of the one end of the fork is t1. So consider the parameter or area resisting tearing across the slot. Area resisting tearing across the slot will be, what will be the area? There are two ends, upper end and lower end, so that multiply by 2. Due to that 2, what will be the area? D2 minus D1, D2 minus D1 into T1. This is the area under the tensile stress or in the tension. So the induced tensile stress is given by sigma t equal to P upon area. Therefore P divided by area will be 2 into d2 minus d1 into t1. Therefore put the value, or therefore values are P sigma t equal to 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by 2 into d2 is 56, d1 is 28, t1 is, what is t1? What is the value of t1? T1 is 21. The tensile stress will get the value of tensile stress is, when you are putting the calci in the calci, 25.51 newton per mm square, which is less than 56 newton per mm square. Therefore here also the 56 is maximum, 25 is minimum, so it is a permissible and it is induced. So the induced tensile stress is less than the permissible tensile stress, means this fork end in the tension or the fork end is safe, the design is safe for the given value. Step 7th, checking the failure of fork end in crushing. Similarly, like a single eye, checking first of all in tension, after in crushing, and after that in shear, one by one. So we have checked for the fork is in the tension. Now we are considering in the shear crushing, and after that we are considering in the shear. So similarly, like a single eye, this area, this area of single eye is under the crushing stress or will under the crushing failure. So in this also, checking for safe crushing, the induced crushing stress should not exceed the permissible crushing stress. We have to check in this step. The area resisting crushing for fork end or a fork end will become, area will be how much of end? Two ends, one and two. Second, which consideration will require in this area? Okay, sorry, it is a come by mistake. In this area we have to consider only. What will be the area? This is a D1 and T1. Because it is the upper end, it is a lower end. Due to that 2 multiplied by 2, only this area, means multiply by T1 into how much? This much. So D, the area will become 2 into T1 into D1. So therefore induced crushing stress sigma CK equal to P upon area is 2 into T1 into D1. Therefore put the value sigma CK equal to 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by 2 into t1. What is the value of t1? T1 is 21 and d1 is 28. Therefore, sigma ck equal to 25.51 newton per mm square, which is also less than given is 70 newton per mm square. So in this also the induced stress is less than the permissible limit. Come to the next step, step 8, checking the failure of fork end in shear. So in shearing, again it is having two ends, 1 and 2, and again having two surfaces. Okay, so as like again a single eye or like a single eye multiply by 2, again multiply by 2 due to double shear, again sorry this is the area, okay, due to that 2 multiply by 2, again multiply by 2 because of double shear, two surfaces are there, okay, into what will be the distance whenever d2 by 2, okay, like this. So it becomes d2 minus d2 by 2 minus d1 by 2, it will d2 minus d1 divided by 2. So d2 minus d1 divided by 2 to get cancelled into t1. Therefore this area becomes 2 into d2 minus d1 into t1, isn't it? So therefore the shear stress tau is given by P upon area. P upon area is 2 d2 minus d1 into t1. Therefore put the values, 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by 2 into 56 minus 28 into 21. So tau will be, how much will be tau? Tau will be 25.51 newton per mm square, which is also less than 35 newton per mm square. Here also the permissible is 35 and induced is 25, so that induced crushing stress is less than the permissible limit. So come to the next step, checking the failure of knuckle pin in shear. Already we have calculated the diameter in second step and we have studied the how the shear failure will occur of knuckle pin. So in this step we are just checking the how much of shear stress will be induced in the knuckle pin. So therefore already area we have considered, so area under shearing will be, what will be the area? 2 into y2 because of these two surfaces multiply by 2 which are in contact with each other and develop the shear stress, and it is a circular cross section area, so it is will become pi by 4 into what will be the diameter? D1 square. This is the area. So therefore induce shear stress will be P upon area, P upon 2 into pi by 4 d1 square, 2 into, therefore put the values, 30 into 10 raised to power 3 divided by into 2, this 2 will goes upper side, pi into d1 square, or d1 square equal to r into, sorry, we have to calculate only tau. So d1 square, so d1 square value of d1 square is, what is d1? 28 bracket square. So the induced shear stress for the pin is will be 24.36 newton per mm square, which is less than 35 newton per mm square. Hence it is proved that our design is safe, or all the induced stresses are within the permissible limit, hence the design is safe. We have to say this line because we are checking in all the steps whether induced stress is minimum or not. So thank you very much for watching my video. Please like, comment and share to my channel TechMech Talent. Thank you.